Let's not beat around the bush and talk about LG G8X's dual display straight away. So, unlike other foldable smartphones, the secondary display on the G8X isn't an intrinsic part of the phone. Rather, it comes as part of a folding case which you get with the phone's retail packaging. Now, here's how it works. You simply put the G8X inside the case, which comes with a USB Type-C connector at the bottom. The connector feeds the power to the secondary screen, and just like that, you now have a phone with two displays. Now, interestingly, the secondary screen works independently to the main display. So the obvious question is the dual screen approach by LG any good? Well, the answer to that isn't as clear as a yes or a no. You see, the secondary screen does add a lot of cool features to the mix, and I noticed that it had two clear benefits over a phone with a single display. Firstly, multitasking between apps. So you could be browsing your Twitter feed on one pane whilst watching a video on the other. And say you're making dinner reservations. So you could just talk to your friends on WhatsApp on one display whilst browsing through restaurant selections on Zomato on the other. In a similar fashion, you could pay attention to your friend's Uber trip on one pane and do something else on the other. The possibilities are countless, and these are all the things which we come across on a day-to-day basis. In a nutshell, the G8X ensures that you don't have to switch between apps as often. Secondly, you'll get a job done much quicker when you're using two displays instead of one. So let's assume that you want to change the wallpaper of your phone. Now, instead of just using one application to browse for new walls, you can have two simultaneously. Similarly, let's say that you're studying for a particular topic. Now, you can compare notes on one display and have a YouTube video playing on the other at the same time. You could even compare the price of a product on two different shopping apps at the same time without having to jump between them. And that's just the tip of the iceberg, mind you. Since the case comes with a pretty solid hinge, you can prop the G8X any way you want to watch videos on it. This is particularly useful in a flight where you can just set the phone down and watch videos without any fuss. LG has also included a bundled gamepad app which can be used on select games, and it's a godsend, honestly. You see, instead of cramming all the buttons and the controls on your main display, you can have them on one of the two screens. This setup allows you to view more of what's going on in the game and dominate your opponents easily. There are multiple gamepad configurations that come bundled with the G8X, and you can even map the controls for a game which is not yet supported for the gamepad. You can also use a lot of cool gestures and tricks on the two screens. For instance, you could swipe with three fingers on the left or right to throw an app on the main or the secondary screen. You can also view your notifications with the case slapped to the phone, as it comes with a tiny monochromatic display on the front. And you can snap the phone shut to end a call in a very dramatic way too. So, where did the company go wrong? Well, firstly, for the most part, having the case on the smartphone all the time is quite cumbersome. Here's a quick list as to why. Number one, the phone becomes much thicker, making it protrude outwards when it's in your pocket. Then answering phone calls also takes an extra step, as you have to unfold the secondary screen, and lest I forget, typing with the case on is not as much fun. Also, if you have a pair of earphones with an L-shaped connector, then you won't be able to fit them through the case's headphone jack slot. Also, it's difficult to use the rear-facing cameras with the case on. Moreover, as good as the case is for multitasking, it still brings the LG G8X nowhere close to what you can do with actual foldable phones like the Galaxy Fold. For one, you have very limited support to scale a particular app on both the displays, and even with the apps that do run on a wider screen, you'll have to deal with misaligned buttons and other UI glitches. Secondly, you can't open the same app on the two screens. So if you want to see two different photos, you'll have to use two different gallery apps like Google Photos and the default gallery one. Thirdly, the gamepad, which I was raving about a while ago, well, that's not without its faults either. So on the games that don't support the gamepad, mapping buttons can be a chore. And even if you do get it right, the gamepad still doesn't let you map two functions to the same button. So in games like Call of Duty, you won't be able to move and shoot, which basically means that you can't play the game using the gamepad. Now, if you do end up buying the LG G8X, chances are that you'll use it just like I did. So in my usage, I use the G8X as a phone, and whenever I wanted to multitask properly, I would take out the dual screen case from my bag. I always had it on me, but I never really had it attached to the phone constantly. Now, you need to remember that this is purely a functional case. This is not something that LG wants you to have on its phone all the time. For that, they have bundled a separate TPU protective case in the box. Now, the G8X doesn't come with a gradient back or has fancy colors, but I like the minimalistic approach the company has taken to make the phone. From the camera cameras on the back, which sit flush with the phone's frame, to the device's curvy edges, which make it a joy to grip, the G8X is among the better looking phones in the market. And it's quite tough too. For one, the phone is IP68 certified, so you can take it with you in a pool or shower and not worry about damaging it. It is also military standard 810G certified, making it more resilient to drops than most other devices in the market, and has a layer of Corning Gorilla Glass version 5 on the front and the back, making it more immune to scuffs and dings. As for the rest of the design, the smartphone comes with a dedicated Google Assistant key on its left hand spine, so you can use that to quickly search something online. And my favorite feature from all the LG phones is back on the G8X2. A 32-bit quad DAC which offers the best-in-class audio output from the 3.5mm headphone jack. Honestly, songs relayed through the DAC sound so good that I actually didn't feel like using my Fio X3 high-res audio player when I was using the G8X. You'll also get an in-display fingerprint sensor with the phone, which isn't the quickest in the market. And making matters worse for the company is that the G8X doesn't support facial recognition, which is a reckless omission in my opinion. Frankly speaking, it made me want to use the phone less and less. For display, the G8X uses a 6.4-inch G-OLED panel with a Full HD Plus resolution. The panel is extremely sharp, gets really bright outdoors, boasts excellent viewing angles, and exhibits tasteful, punchy colors. It also comes with support for Widevine L1 and HDR10 certification, so you can stream your favorite movies in high resolution from apps like Netflix and Prime. The only downside of the panel is that it's locked at 60Hz, and therefore it doesn't feel as fluid as the display on the OnePlus 7T. The LG G8X is backed by Qualcomm's Snapdragon 855 processor, which works alongside 6GB of RAM and 128GB of built-in user-expandable UFS 2.1 storage. Now, going by the specs, you can tell that the G8X isn't the most powerful smartphone out there. In fact, the OnePlus 7T, which costs much less, offers a better processor, more RAM, and faster UFS 3.1 storage to boot. This is clearly evident when you run synthetic benchmarks on the G8X, wherein the device scored considerably lower than the 7T. In AnTuTu benchmark, the G8X scored 417,481 points, which is almost 70,000 points less than what the 7T scored. However, the 855 is still a very capable processor, and I didn't feel any issues with it during my time with the phone. Apps opened quickly, I could comfortably multitask between half a dozen applications, and the phone allowed me to play games like PUBG and Call of Duty at the highest possible settings. To give you a better picture, the G8X ran PUBG on HDR preset and extreme frame rates without any fuss. All in all, while the G8X isn't the fastest phone in the market, it's not a slob either. Software has been LG's Achilles heel for some time now, and although the G8X has made strides in making the company's custom skin feel cleaner, it could still do better. Now, on the whole, I didn't find many issues with the G8X software, and it even comes with some interesting features. For instance, there's a context awareness utility bundled with the phone, which automatically changes your Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and sound settings depending upon your location. So, if you're at home, the phone will automatically turn on or off your preferred settings. You also get features like a floating bar, which you can use to access shortcuts on your device quickly. And the phone also comes with support for utilities like a dark mode, a theme store, and digital well-being, along with support for Project Treble, which means that the phone should, at least in theory, get quick updates. Unfortunately, the device ships with a lot of bloatware which eat up into the system storage. And it's a little disappointing to see that LG hasn't updated its flagship smartphone to Android 10 either. Moreover, I faced issues when installing and using certain apps like Uber on the phone too, which simply refused to lock onto my location. Other apps like Premiere Rush just won't show up on the Play Store when you're using the G8X. Everything considered, LG needs to better the software experience on the G8X. The LG G8X is fueled by a 4000mAh battery, which comfortably lasted me an entire day. Now, this could be due to the phone's 60Hz display, but I was easily averaging over 6.5 hours of screen on time with the phone. However, the phone does take a long time to recharge, and in our battery charge test, the device took 2 hours and 20 minutes to get back to 100% from scratch. Now, compared to flagship phones like the X2 Pro, which charges completely in just 30 minutes, that's a little subpar. Also, you get support for wireless charging with the phone, which also works if you have the case on
And if you're worried about charging the phone with a wired connection when the case is on, then you should know that the company supplies a magnetic latch inside the retail unit of the box, which simply connects to your Type-C cable and allows you to charge the phone in wired connection with the case on.
The LG G8X features a dual camera setup at the back comprising a 12 megapixel main shooter and a 13 megapixel wide angle sensor with a 136 degrees field of view. For selfies, the phone comes equipped with a 32 megapixel selfie camera. Now, coming to the quality of the photos, the LG G8X manages to click compelling photos with its 12 megapixel main camera during the day. The best part about the photos is that they're very realistic, and you'd be hard pressed to find another phone in the market which clicks as true to life shots as the G8X does. Moreover, the smartphone boasts excellent dynamic range too, and the sensor can pick up details from the shadows quite efficiently. And even in tricky scenarios, the cameras outputted a well-exposed image. However, the photos lack crispness, and I noticed that landscape images were quite over-sharpened. Switching over to the photos of human subjects in daylight, I noticed that the phone softened my skin tone quite a bit. Now, compared to a similarly priced flagship in the form of the 70 Pro, the G8X's photos did leave quite a bit to be desired. In a similar fashion, while the phone's wide-angle camera lets you get creative with your shots, the details in the photos are nowhere to be seen. Making matters worse, the edges of the pictures have quite a lot of blurriness, so you'd be better off taking a step or two back to capture a fuller scene instead of solely relying on the wide-angle camera. Now, that being said, the phone clicks incredible close-ups, and as can be seen from the sample shots I've attached, the images are on par, if not better, than the competition in this category. On the flip side, the portrait shots from the rear camera could use some tweaking, as you can tell that the blur effect seeps into the edges of my jeans and ears. At night, the phone managed to output decent images, but there was considerable noise in the shots upon zooming in. That and the photos turned out soft, which to LG's credit isn't just an issue with the G8X, and almost all smartphones struggle to click photos in low light. However, said devices also bettered the output of the photos when I used their dedicated night mode, something which the G8X didn't. Simply put, the night mode on the phone is extremely finicky, and 9 times out of 10, I couldn't tell if a photo was clicked with the night mode enabled or if it was just a standard low light shot. LG has a bad rap when it comes to front cameras on its phones. However, it's safe to say that the company has turned a new leaf with the G8X, as the smartphone's 32 megapixel selfie shooter captured excellent self-portraits with ample details, well-balanced exposure, and natural-looking colors. The front camera also comes with studio lighting mode, which is fun to use, albeit I doubt you'd be using it as often as the regular mode. If the company could improve one thing, I'd say that they should work on the portrait mode for the front cam, which doesn't create a consistent blur effect around the edges of the subject. As for videos, the LG G8X shoots incredible footage from its rear cameras. The smartphone can record all the way up to 4K 60fps, and the footage in every single mode turned out great. The clips were stabilized to an extent where my co-workers thought I was using a gimbal, the colors were on point, and the smartphone handled the shift in dynamic range and focus admirably too. What's more, the device features an ASMR mode which increases the microphone sensitivity, thereby making the audio output sound louder and clearer.
So guys, now we are going to shoot 4K 60fps footage from the G8X. Since it's a flagship phone, it does come with support for 4K 60fps footage, sensitive to the audio. So do let me know if that is the case or not. Compare it with the normal 1080p 60fps footage and tell me if the audio quality is better or not.
And unlike some flagships, you can seamlessly transition from normal to wide-angle mode whilst recording videos. LG is also big on manual controls for its video mode, and the company has incorporated a lot of tools for pro videographers too. So if you want to tweak the ISO or white balance of your footage, or monitor the audio output for the left and right stereo channels, you can do that with the G8X. So where does that leave us? Well, the LG G8X ThinQ retails for ₹49,990, and for that price, it does bring a lot of enticing features to the table, including the dual screen case, a solid battery life, excellent audio output from both the headphone jack as well as the loudspeaker, and good performance. Now, the way I see it, people wanting to buy the LG G8X will probably fall in one of three categories. So firstly, either you are extremely interested in the concept of foldable smartphones, and in that case, the G8X ThinQ does make a convincing case for itself. Now, the software for the secondary screen is a bit limited right now, but one can hope that the company will bring more and more features down the line. Secondly, you could just like LG phones in general, be it for their excellent video shooting capabilities or their phenomenal audio output from both the headphone jack as well as the loudspeaker. Now, if that's the case, then don't go for the G8X, but buy the G8S instead, which offers the same internal specifications, the same amazing 32-bit hi-fi quad DAC, but it also gives you a telephoto camera at the back along with facial recognition for biometric authentication. So that, in my opinion, is the better LG phone of the two. Now, thirdly, you could just want a new smartphone, right? You could just be in the market for a new phone. So if that's the case, then I would say that the LG G8X doesn't quite cut it amidst the competition, the likes of which include the OnePlus 7T and the Realme X2 Pro, as they just offer a better package in general. So guys, with that, our in-depth review of the LG G8X comes to an end. Do let us know in the comments below if you enjoyed.